This is the big breaking story at this hour. IndiGo, the first off the block to officially express an interest in Air India's assets. As Ashpreet Sethi was reporting there, Aditya Ghosh, the chief of IndiGo, wrote a letter right after the cabinet meeting on the 28th of June expressing the airline's interest. They've given two options there. One, of course, is just the standalone international operations, and the other is both the international as well as the domestic operations. Let's go across now to Jitendra Bhargav. Mr. Bhargav, thanks very much. Are you at all surprised that IndiGo is the first off the block in terms of expressing officially its interest in Air India?
See, a bit surprised at the pace at which they've responded. The fact that the airlines would be interested, I was very sure about it right from day one. The moment government Niti Aayog gave a recommendation on privatization, I knew airlines would be interested because Air India has a lot of intrinsic value, something that outsiders do not know but insiders are aware of. Now let's look at from IndiGo's perspective. They are India's number one domestic player. No doubt about it. But can the same be said about the international? No. Air India is India's largest player on the international market. Look at what IndiGo gets in one go if they were to eventually succeed. They are absent from Europe, United States, Asia Pacific, New Zealand, Australia. Now all in one go you get this whole market with the fleet, with operations going, steady market. And once you have the private sector, work culture, productivity, use of assets of both men and machines, you see the kind of phenomenal change in the benefits it gives. We should not be judging Air India's current losses and profit kind of a thing or the capability to break even, because that's with all the government negatives that they have in the system, inbuilt into the system. The moment you have productivity increasing, you see the kind of spectacular gains a private sector can reap.
Amber Dubey, as Mr. Bhargav there was pointing out, and this is the conversation that I've been having with several people within the aviation sector, that as far as domestic airlines are concerned, Air India is the ticket to expand international operations. In fact, that is the lucrative opportunity that most people are eyeing, the kind of bilateral rights that Air India enjoys. You think that this is going to boil down to the international play that Air India offers?
Right, Shireen, we've always maintained that the Air India is sitting on a tremendous value. This is untapped potential, as has already been mentioned by Mr. Bhargav also. And in the whole negativity around the losses and the humongous debt, these assets are never talked about. Those slots are not available. The fleet is not available. The institutional knowledge of Air India is of huge value. So I guess, and we've always maintained that if the government just takes the bold step of putting the airline on the block, there will be at least two or three domestic players who might be interested. So not surprised, very happy. Shireen?
Mr. Bhargav, you know, we had Ajay Singh and I spoke with him in D.C. Where Prime Minister Modi was meeting with President Donald Trump, and SpiceJet has just signed that mega 205 aircraft order with Boeing. And when I put this question to him on whether they would be interested in Air India, he said that we're too small. But now, given the fact that IndiGo is first off the block and has expressed its intent to go after Air India, do you think that SpiceJet might want to change its mind?
You know, there will be a difference between SpiceJet as well as IndiGo. SpiceJet has come out of a crisis just 2 years ago. It is still developing its market, still acquiring aircraft and expanding its operations, largely on the domestic sector. If you see the kind of planes that they've ordered, regional connectivity planes and those kind of things available. Now, what is IndiGo? They have established themselves as the numero uno player in the domestic market. They have placed orders to add to the fleet, and they will keep expanding the market and retain their market share, if not expand as far as the domestic sector is concerned. But they haven't really ordered aircraft which are for long-haul operations. So that is where I see you leverage the advantage of Air India being there, and you said, all right, in one go, IndiGo becomes a global international airline with operations in domestic, Gulf, Southeast Asia. You really can't describe IndiGo as a global player at the moment, an international thing in league with Lufthansa, British Airways and other airlines. But the moment if they were to acquire eventually Air India, they come in that same league. Membership of Star Alliance, a whole lot of engineering base that you have, of course, much depends on the way the government is going to be selling off the stakes in Air India, whether it's just the airline or it's going to be with the ground handling, engineering, MROs and other kind of things. Because in my opinion, considered view, selling just the airline may not be it, because while the emphasis 15 days ago, if you recall, the whole of media was talking about the dead part of it. yes, from yesterday onwards, yeah. after the finance minister briefed the press from the cabinet meeting, he laid equal emphasis on the assets. Now, something that narrative that we were upset right. about it earlier, but now I think government is in the right narrative. And that is why, whether it's the finance secretary who says, there is a lot of positivity. IndiGo's response, again, lent proof to it. Now, I'm very confident as we go along and as government brings in greater clarity and put it in public domain, you have still bigger response. Though my thing remains, it must be an Indian entity that must acquire Air India.
You believe that it should be an Indian entity that will acquire Air India. Amber Dubey, you know, the civil aviation minister as well as the Minister of State for Aviation in their conversations with me had said that nothing is off the table. This was in response to a specific question whether they would allow foreign carriers to bid for Air India. Mr. Bhargav's point of view is that ownership should be retained with an Indian entity. But do you think that foreign carriers would at all be interested realistically in Air India?
No, again, the risk of repetition, Shireen, I'll say that the assets of Air India are not much talked about. They carry tremendous value, especially the bilateral rights. So, and the slots are not available either in Delhi, Mumbai, or in the JFKs or the Heathrows, right? So there is a value which any global or domestic airline would be interested in. Coming back to the first part of your question, in the first round, given the emotional connect and the fact that this is a national carrier, the first attempt would be to sell it to a domestic player. If we don't get a good player, or the price is not right, or the terms and conditions which they put forth is not palatable to the government, in that case, maybe in round two, yeah. The government may decide to go for a global carrier. Shireen?
Okay. Mr. Bhargav, you know, we also understand, and this is of course not official information but source-based information, that the government may have informally reached out to large Indian conglomerates as well. You know, the Tatas being the most obvious one, but there are perhaps others as well that the government has reached out to. Strategically though, do you believe that the best fit would really be an existing domestic carrier, and hence the edge or the advantage would be to somebody like IndiGo?
You see, in order of preference, A, an Indian entity, irrespective of whether they are currently in aviation business or not. Second, yes, somebody who has the requisite experience, it will give Air India the kind of necessary impetus needed without any delay. Third thing is the most, or the first preferred choice, I would put it this way, will be the House of Tatas. On a simple emotional connect, A, they founded the airline, it's only justifiable, they get back. They have the requisite experience, they have the requisite size, nothing better than this, and they have a tie with Singapore Airlines. So they get all the kind of technological advantage, because Air India is not technologically advanced. So you will get that kind of thing right. available, new work practices, which are tried and tested, huge market, marketing set up internationally available. They will be adding value to what Air India already has. And plus, of course, Air India's engineering base, they have a large fleet of their own. Look at the kind of in-house business that can come to Air India itself. So that is why I see an all-in-all total advantageous situation. Tata's number one, Indian carriers number two, and if you have a corporate third, a foreign carrier, or no, absolutely, because Air India is an Indian brand, one of the first Indian global brands. Let's not diminish value of Air India, and that will send out a wrong message that, look, you had such a spectacular airline called Air India once upon a time, but you had none from the Indian entities who could takeover of Air India. Now that, in my opinion, is a humiliating and an embarrassing fact.
All right, so very clear there. Jitendra Bhargav, former ED of Air India, saying that Indian entity, the House of Tatas, IndiGo Airlines, or any other domestic carrier, and only if no one from the first three bucket make the cut, should the government even look at a foreign entity. But Jitendra Bhargav, Amber Dubey, always a pleasure. Many thanks for joining us here on CNBC TV 18. So that is the big story today. IndiGo, first off the block, officially expressing its interest for Air India, giving two options to the Civil Aviation Ministry. Aditya Ghosh writing a letter to the Aviation Minister on the 28th of June, practically moments after the Cabinet decision.